region for 2 minutes.
I beg, make we do the same. Pikin out there. You dey watch the Obonge show, the late night show.
Will you keep quiet? What's wrong to you?
Waiting. After that's doing quite well.
I have a feeling it should be the cure to Ebola because it's so difficult for you to even learn pidgin. Okay, guys, welcome to tonight's episode on the late night show. Trust me, it's Friday, and this is the day we turn up. My name is Elenu. I am the stand-up comedian, husband, brother, boyfriend, and your nigga twice. She was, of course, the presidential aspirant for the late night party. LNP, you know how it is? That's me.
Everyone's boyfriend again, she was she.
I'll move on.
Married man.
Yeah, welcome.
Married.
Don't forget to add the African.
Oh, yeah, my turn.
Married African man.
You don't do my turn, my turn. Hi, guys. I'm Simi Elenu, Omo Ibadan to baddest, to finest, to freshest. The brains, the beauty, be fine, the late night party. I'm also the VP of the LNP party and the minister of no impeachment of the VP. And the minister of impeachment of other ministers.
And another word for flat. Okay, ladies and gentlemen.
I go do Jackie Chan on you one day.
Of course, you know how it is on the late night show. We turn up and this is how we roll. Tonight's guest is one of my favorite, your favorite, our favorite, and you know how it is. He is a tall, dark, and handsome young man. I wouldn't say too young. He's very rich. He's so rich, if he decides to withdraw all of his money from one bank, the bank will bounce. Yes, he's that rich, if you know what I mean. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Award-winning producer, actor, director, great husband, great father, Yemi Blaq.
So now you're telling DJ Lambo to shut up after years of Ashewoism with her.
Hello? Okay, it's going to be a nice
I'm
show.
I'm not getting you. What's wrong here?
DJ Lambo.
Yeah. What's up? I'm good.
Okay.
Yemi, how are you this evening?
Man. I'm great, great.
Now, nice on the show, there. Now you must have heard when we were doing the introductions that we are the late night party.
Cheers.
Table.
Yeah. Great night, yeah.
Yeah. Now we are campaigning for the post of the presidency and vice president. I'm the president, and of course, doubling as the minister of finance. She's nice. VP and other ministries that are not actually important.
They okay. actually are very important. Okay, so now, we give all our guests on the show the opportunity, the chance, once in a lifetime opportunity to create any ministry you want and to be the head of that ministry.
Any ministry that I want.
Are you up to the task?
Oh, great. I would like to be the minister for all religious activities.
Does that all religious, it's fine.
All religious activities. So
approved.
We're covering all spiritual activities from Ifa all the way down to whatever you want to encompass.
We've had the minister of Church Affairs.
Oh, great.
Yeah, we've had the minister religious. Of To Whom. Uh-huh. That was Julius Ibrahim, yeah.
To Whom, yeah?
To Whom. Oh,
nice.
To Whom.
Nice.
And we've had the minister of Girls with Big Booty. Those two ministries are very important to me.
Sure.
Their offices are actually inside the presidency's office.
Well, I mean, hey, well, it's nice to have Girls with Big Booty. I mean, like if, they have, if you drive an SUV, there's a big booty. Boot what?
Oh.
Ask it.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm. Nice one.
Yes, Ministry of All Religions, from Ifa to
anywhere.
Anywhere, good. Yeah.
Mm. So all tithes come to me, I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. But Yemi, it's not just the tithes that come to you. Apparently naked women come to you up here at your
doorstep. Well, I'm not quite certain about that.
Everything that comes to the ministry.
Funny thing is, I think there's a preset to that, because a long time ago, I was working in Abuja. I've told the story a couple of times ago. I was in my room drinking with a couple of guys. The room was shaped in such a way that to make your way in there, you have to come through a small corridor. And I was just sitting on the bed when I heard the knock on the door. I had someone go get it. And I heard a gasp from him. It was a rather dramatic gasp. So I told him, what happened? He came for us. She know where Kloto. So apparently, there was a lady from the opposite room who just crossed the corridor and knocked on my door at 11:35-ish p.m. So I'm just saying, that's a foundation for what you were saying earlier. So, moving on.
She knocked on your door at 11:35-ish.
Butt naked.
Hey. Yeah, I bet she was trying, maybe, I don't know, she was trying to get...
Was she coming out of your room?
She came out of her room. which is opposite mine, yeah. So she knocked on the door, and the guy opened the door, and he saw her stackers there. Till today, I've been wondering. I'm a smart guy. Trust me, I am, by all standards. But I've been wondering exactly what she was doing there, and I still can't fathom. Maybe you guys can help me. I don't know.
Who knows? She left her bras in your...
No idea.
But she had never been in my room before. There was no preset to her being there, so...
Probably a rodent brought it in.
Sleepwalking.
A rodent.
Sleepwalking.
A rodent brought her in, right?
Sleepwalking. Oh, yeah. Yeah, obviously. Obviously.
I'll go with that one.
Who knows? Anything can happen. You know, actually, in Nigeria, the rats here, they take things very personally.
Yes.
Like they say in worry. Now, the rats there, you do not threaten to kill them or try to kill them. Mm. If you try, they wait for you when you are asleep. They do not come to your pot of soup or your money. They go straight to your certificate.
Yes.
If you graduated from the University of Lagos, they eat up the uni, university. And they go to that part of your resort that says first class upper. They eat out the class and leave the upper.
Okay.
I go and get a job. Let's see. Rats
are right, important to life, actually, you know, because some people actually do eat them. Yeah. When I was growing up, I grew up in Ondo Town, Ondo State. And the kids used to catch rodents and eat them. And I wonder how. Anything is smaller than a chicken is hard for me to eat.
I eat only things in the town. Bushmeat, never.
Oh, I like bushmeat, actually. But
No. I don't eat anything.
It has to be of a certain size.
Mm.
Yeah.
Sia for me. Oh. All the way.
My father used to have a hunter. He bought the guy a Dane gun. So the guy would go hunt and bring, you know, like... they call it ishakole. It's like a percentage of what he hunted, and so I ate alligators, I ate my fair share of monkeys, crocodile. There was a time he brought an electric eel and all sorts like that. We actually had a hyena at some point. It was live.
Really?
Yeah.
You ate monkeys?
Oh yes, I did.
Ellen, you might want to run away quickly.
No. No. You didn't say that. You just didn't say that. Go ahead. You're on the slow. You were on the slow cow just now. But moving on. later on tonight, I would not be surprised if I hear the headline is ace comedian Elenu commits homicide in. You know, but let's
put it the way it is in Nigeria. We don't commit homicide in Nigeria.
Don't keep pissing.
Now, what is the worst dare you've ever done?
Mm.
The worst dare I've ever done? Oh, there's a bunch of them I can't remember because it's really... I'm a very adventurous person, so yeah, whenever there's adventure, I have to reel myself from going in. Worst dare I've ever done? Worst dare? I mean, there's so much I can't remember. I really honestly can't. There's too many dares.
Okay, now on this show, we get the audience or the viewers to dare us to do whatever it is they want.
Oh, great.
And we'll pick them up and we'll do quite a few of them.
Great.
She's been dared to ride keke. She sold pure water. I sold sausages in traffic.
Of all things to sell.
She's had to mix.
Of all things to sell, Elenu. Of all things to sell.
Can you imagine?
Yeah. I've also been dared to try and clean windscreen in traffic. Great. She's been dared to mix okra, ketchup, and juice, and she drank it. So,
yummy.
It wasn't as good as monkey, but what can I say?
You're still going there.
I'm still going there.
Are you still going there?
I'm still going there.
Okay, all right then.
Respect yourself.
I'm respecting
myself.
You're
not far from the electric fish.
I'm going to invest in a really
nice... Really quiet. Yeah?
Okay, so this is one of the viewers dared me to do this, and I had to do it.
Oh, and by the way, Yemi, you can also dare one of us.
Yes.
Or Elenu, if you want to.
Why one of us?
To do something in here or out on the street.
It could be here.
Or it could be outside. We'll go and record it and share it in one of our future episodes.
Why not? So let's see what I was there to do.
Okay, guys, you're still on the late night show with Elenu and Simi. My name is Elenu, and somebody dared me to dress up as a vulcanizer and try to fix someone's tire. So I'm going to take a quick crash course, and then I'll try to see if I can fix one tire. Here's my Oga, who will be teaching me on how to fit a quick tire. So Oga, how do we start? Trying to fix somebody's tire. tell you now. I told you. That original. It's original. So. Oh. To do this, but I'm going to learn for the first time. To be a man, it's not a danger. Bring it to you. So I've tried removing the tire, assuming that I fixed it back. Now I'm going to pump it. So my boss is now going to tell me what next I'm going to do. So I need to gauge now to see. And I've been able to gauge. Remove. My name is Elenu. Back to Simi and me in the studio. Bye-bye.
What?
You're Mr. Volkanazar. It suits you. It fits you.
Oh, thank you. Treasurer.
And you don't need to worry about the sun making you black, because you're blacker than Yemi Blaq, who is still with us on the show tonight.
Hey, this is my brother. Yeah, from...
Another mother.
Yeah.
All right, Yemi, have you thought of a dare you'd like to dare Elenu?
Why me?
Oh, yeah, I've thought about it. I've been thinking long and hard. and I want to thrust into the situation rather quickly. I think that it would be nice to have a stripper pole set up here and have you on it. Yeah, and do a really nice striptease. I would love to watch that on the show.
Executive producer, I don't know how you want to do it this. Madam Tatiana, please, we need to get that poll.
Yeah.
I'm interested in this particular day.
Yes, please. I'd like to see her.
I'm very, very interested in it.
And I mean, with the right costume.
We repeat it four times.
Yeah, with the right costume, with the right attitude and the right dance.
She's a size one.
Yes.
Right?
Not 0.5, please. Be specific.
1.5, yes.
No, it's 0.5, not 1.5.
Oh, you are that fat now?
She's just size 0.5. She's not one yet.
Okay. And on that note, we'll go for a quick break. And we'll be right back after this.